Okay, hi everyone. It's Niamh here from our customer success team. You're getting a double whammy from our customer success team as well today, because we also have Ev joining us. So I'm sure some of you have already spoken to us at one point and the other. If this is the first time you are speaking to either one of us or seeing either one of us, it's lovely to speak with you all, and thank you so much for joining today. We are going to be talking about sales tax today. So thank you very much for joining on such a juicy, juicy topic, which Ev and I are very, very excited to be talking about. But all kidding aside, this is a really exciting feature that we are releasing and one that is in high demand for an awful lot of our customers. So we are super confident that you're going to get an awful lot from this, particularly for anybody who has the tax exclusive setup. That's definitely one that you're going to want to pay attention to whenever we're running through those demos and how get kickstarted. So before we run into any demos, Ev is going to give us a quick run through what we'll be talking about today and really getting us kicked off with this webinar.
Hello everyone, Eve here. Very nice to see you all. I'm excited to share the agenda of today. So let's just go through it. First, we'll address why sales tax is important and how this feature will help you run your business. We will show you how to use sales tax in GloFox. So in other words, we'll be walking you through how to set up the sales tax, how to create the rates, and also how to assign tax rates to product and service group. Also, what's new with sales tax in GloFox, and we'll go over its key features. Managing tax exclusive prices. We'll go over a step-by-step guide for tax exclusive customers. If you don't know what that is yet, don't you worry. We'll go over it and we'll show you plenty of examples. And then we will share some resources to help you with any additional other questions that you have around sales tax. And of course, we'll answer any questions you may have. You can always drop your questions here in the Q&A, and at any time you can always reach out to our support team after the webinar. If you have more questions, you can reach out to your onboarding manager if you're still in the middle of your onboarding process, or your customer success manager. All right, now let's go over why sales tax is important. So the first thing, stay compliant with the law. So the legal rate of sales tax varies between region and obviously can change from year to year. So we've made it very simple for you to apply multiple tax rates. And again, we'll show you more examples. But if you are a Canadian or US-based studio, you know exactly what I'm talking about. So for instance, if you're having the price tag of your product, for instance, is $10, you will have the ability to display $10 and then add the tax. So again, if you're in a region where tax exclusive is used, you'll find this feature very, very, very useful. Then save time configuring your tax rate. As we know, sales tax is automatically applied at the point of sales based off your pre-tax prices and the tax rates assigned in GloFox. So you won't have to worry about calculating the tax for each product and services. Then reduce the workload of updating your accounts. So the sales tax feature is designed to simplify year-end accounting for the studios. What does that mean? It means that you will have access to the reports, the sales tax report, directly on your dashboard under the reports tab. Assign the right tax rate to the right product and services. So you will have the ability to assign different tax rate. Again, what does that mean? If you have a membership that you and you would like to apply a 10% tax on the membership, you can apply 10%, and then you can choose to apply an 8% tax on a product, for instance. And then lastly, maximize sales by having clear pricing displayed to your customers. So you'll have the ability to show the price to your members before tax and after tax. So that's basically why sales tax is important. What do you think, Niamh?
Yeah, no, I think that's
important.
It's just so important. I think about it every single day while I drink my coffee. All joking aside, I think those points are super, super relative. And as you see how we have constructed the product, you'll see that we really have thought about this in, you know, quite in depth to make sure that not only is it really easy for you to set up, but it also takes in the real priorities and why sales tax is needed. And you'll see how we've incorporated that into the product with this current version of the feature. So as Ev has alluded to there, what we have supported is, you know, a means for you to set up your sales tax percentages, be it that you have a tax inclusive setup or a tax exclusive setup. We will go through, as I said, demos and going through how to get all those set up. But as Ev mentioned as well, you know, if it's a case that you have different types of tax percentages, with how we have configured sales tax at this point, is that you're now able to have different tax percentages for different service groups and products as well. So what I mean by that is that if you've got a different sales tax, be it for your classes, for your courses, for your product types, for your memberships, you will be able to have different tax percentages there. And I quite enjoy the layout of how this is, so I'm excited to kind of show you how that is broken down and how you can easily apply it. Also from a reporting perspective, and you know, from your own kind of records, it's very easy for you to see the tax percentages broken down in your tax reports now, in your transaction reports. So again, we've really tried to tick all the boxes here in terms of how it's going to be aesthetically pleasing for your customers, which is how we've, you know, broken it down in terms of how the sales tax is presented separately in your cart, while also in the receipts for your clients, but also for the business in terms of actually setting up your sales tax, changing any sales tax depending on if it changes from year to year, as Ev alluded to. The final piece here may not be 100% relevant for some of our existing customer base, but definitely something to take note of if it's the case that you have a second business with another software provider and you're just jumping to get that into GlowFox. We will be able to support the transactions data migration as well with sales tax. So that's something to bear in mind. And if it's the case even that you do know of somebody in the fitness industry that is looking for software and maybe that's kind of a barrier as to why they've actually made the move, well, at least now you know that GlowFox can support that quite easily. So if you need any more information about that, you just let us know. We won't touch on it again throughout the webinar. We're just going to focus more so on the demos, but definitely reach out if it's the case that you want to learn a little bit more information about that. While I get the demo prepared here, I'll let you run through this on how we can get the sales tax set up.
Yes, so we made it very, like just Niamh mentioned, we made it very easy to set up your sales tax. So Niamh will use our demo account. So basically what we did is we added a tab in your settings. All you'll have to do is click on your settings on the top right corner of your screen. Then you'll have to, as Niamh is showing here, we have the tax tab. And then through that tab, this is how you'll be able to set up the feature. Very easy. Niamh, whenever you're ready, would you like to okay, perfect. I'll mute myself. You go.
It's all good. Thank you, Ev. I think we're both just so excited to demo this that we just want to give it both a go. As Ev said, before, if you recall how getting sales tax set up, it was just in one section here on the studio details page. However, now, as Ev said, you can clearly see that there's an entire section in the settings dedicated to tax. So quite clearly from the offset, you can see that you can choose between price includes tax or does not include tax. So that's going to be your tax exclusive. That's what we are referring to. From the get-go, before making any changes, you know, before deciding what sales tax percentages are in place, you want to really make sure you know which one you are choosing, because that will be set from, you know, the time that you start making these changes. So it's not the case that you can chop and choose between the two. So very much, you know, depending on what is, you know, required within your region, and you know, now's the time to decide it. And obviously here again, you have the option to add your trading name here, your tax ID number, and then here is very much the holy grail where you can add your different tax rates. So as you can see from some of the examples that are already laid out, you've got your new tax, local tax, whatever very much is relevant to where you are at this point. It could change from, you know, from location to location. So what we've allowed you to do here is by selecting add text, you can go and add your own name to this. So I'm just going to use one that's already in place here, for example, and just type local tax and then your percentage. You can see already I can't save anything unless I have a percentage rate in place there. And at this point, you can choose what tax or what rate this is associated with, or what, excuse me, service group this is associated with. So you can choose from the offset whether this is for classes, whether this is for memberships, or you can just save that as, you know, a tax rate and not apply it to anything at all. Once you save and close, that will then save in your tax rates, and down on your products and services area, this is where you will then apply the tax. So you can see from the example, from the examples already, you can, you know, add taxes on top of each other, meaning that classes will both have the new tax and the service tax applied. So that's going to be broken down clearly on the checkout card, for example, and also on the receipt. So we'll jump a little bit quickly back in to see how that will visually, or how that will be shown on the breakdown and so on. But as you can see, it's super clear, super simple. It's not, it doesn't require much, you know, rocket science to actually get this set up. It's just a matter of just opening it up, adding the new tax rate and or applying the tax rate to the service group, saving that, and then that will then apply. So Ed, we'll jump back and we can run through, let's say, how this can be in place for, I guess, for staff whenever they're processing any transactions here on the dashboard, and also what it will look like as well on the receipts, which I know have definitely gotten a glow up. So I think it's going to be exciting to share that.
Yes, yes. Thank you, Niamh. So yes, exactly. So the view, the slide that you see here is, so I'm a staff member, so that's how it will look like. So as you know that little box, that's the checkout tab here. So we have the two different choices, right, that we've been going on. We talked about the tax exclusive and the tax inclusive. The difference, again, just to be clear, tax exclusive means that the pricing, right, the, let's say the $10 in this example here, that's the price of the really expensive bottle of water, quality water here. And then the total price is $12, which means that the breakdown of the tax here is $2, right? So the pricing, the price tag does not include the tax. And then we have on the right, the tax inclusive. Tax inclusive means we have our $10 bottle of water, the total amount is still $10, and then you have the breakdown of the sales tax within your showing in the checkout. So I hope this is clear. We made it very easy, as you can see, to see the breakdown. Same thing with the receipt tax here. This is this tax, the example here, this is an email receipt that is being emailed to your members when they purchase an item. So for instance, again, if you look on the left side, you see the tax exclusive, and the tax exclusive in this example, I believe is $7. And then the total is, I believe, $9.10, which means that the tax is not included in the price. And same thing with tax inclusive that we just talked about, the tax is already included in the price. Let us know if you have any questions on this, but this is pretty straightforward. This is the new way and the new look of our receipt, and we are, I think we made it very clear for your members.
Yeah, exactly, Ev. And I think, again, it is quite broken down. And once you get to see it, and once you know that this is the way that you want it to be presented, or this is what is required wherever you are, you can, I guess, sleep soundly knowing that it's going to be presented quite aesthetically pleasing for all of your clients as well. So from a business perspective, so we've just shown you how that works for, let's say, your staff if they're processing transactions, you know, the breakdown on receipts. But then from a transactions report, you will also see that there's a breakdown of the different tax rates on the transactions as well. So once you download that report, I'll give you a quick glance on what that actually looks like on a downloaded transactions report. Once we go in and start showing you how to kind of amend or kind of select your prices. But yeah, so that's something that you should be looking forward to as much as you can get excited about with sales tax, that it will be now available on your transactions report. So whenever you are configuring your sales tax exclusive, obviously at the moment, an awful lot of you who are on this call, on this webinar, you have probably either already set up your dashboard to be tax inclusive, but you may want that option to, you know, branch out into a tax exclusive. So if it's the case that you may have dropped off somewhere along in this webinar and you're wondering when to start paying attention, now is the time, particularly if it's the case that you have a tax exclusive setup. So initially, if you're a brand new customer and you're setting up your tax exclusive rates, you select prices do not include your tax. If it's the case you're already an existing client and all of your prices at the moment are tax inclusive, then what you need to do whenever you are changing your taxes is, first of all, you can go ahead and ensure that all of your details in terms of, you know, your trading name, your tax ID, your different types of tax rates, that you have them all set out as we showed you in that initial demo. So you've got your local tax, and that's applied, let's say, onto products, that's applied onto memberships. So you really kind of lay out what is what. But before you go and select price does not include, you want to make sure that you keep your option, your initial option, as price includes tax. So the reason why I am suggesting or advising that is that in between that interim of when you are setting up all of your taxes and when, you know, you want to start, you know, distinguishing between tax inclusive and exclusive, some transactions may go on ahead. Now, if it's the case that you're in some regions at the moment where lockdown is going live and strong and you've completely closed up shop, then this is a good time to start doing some of these changes. But if you are still running your business, which is what we really, really love to hear, what we recommend so that you do not double charge your clients in terms of tax is ensuring that you select prices include tax. So what happens is that whenever you are going in to change all of your prices, you exit out here, and let's say we'll go into manage and we go into store. Now, instead of saying that your headphones, for example, are $10, which would have included tax previously in the past, we go into variance. And we go and select, let's say, whatever that price may be without the tax included. So here, this just makes sure that your clients are not going to get double charged and that you're not charging them tax twice. So before, you know, changing any of your prices, you really want to make sure that all of your prices in your store, in your membership, do not include tax, that they are set at the pre-tax rate. And then whenever you go and configure your tax, then you can choose that the pricing excludes tax. And that way, then you make sure that you are not double charging your clients. So if, you know, whenever you are setting this out and whenever you are setting up all of your tax rates, if you do have any concerns and you're not, you know, entirely sure what to do, you know, don't worry. We have a ton of actual support here on how you can make sure that, you know, you have your sales tax set up and configured correctly. So you can see we have this webinar in place, but we also have, you know, a lot more kind of content on our knowledge base. So that's something that you definitely want to make sure that you do jump in and review before you start making any of those changes. Ev, is there anything that you want to add to that, just to make sure that we've covered everything? Because I know that this is kind of something that we definitely want to make sure that our clients are super aware of.
Yeah, no, I think it's great. Thank you for that. And of course, if you guys have any questions, you can always reach out to our team. And of course, again, if you have any questions regarding this feature, we have, I'd like for those of you that are not aware that we have a knowledge base, I invite you to visit our knowledge base online. Our team constantly work on updating the content of the knowledge base with tips, articles, videos. So don't hesitate to visit our knowledge base. So our team updated the knowledge base with a few articles relevant to what we just talked about. For instance, the sales tax in GloFox, how to set up sales tax in GloFox for tax inclusive, same thing with tax exclusive, and then FAQ, configuring sales tax in GloFox. So again, if you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out to your customer success manager, your onboarding manager, the support team. We're here to help.
Exactly, Ev. And I think, as you can see, we are already so excited about sales tax. So that excitement filters out throughout the entire company. So if you do have any questions about it, it's not going to be considered as a silly or a boring question by any means at all. We're super proud of this product and we just know that it's going to be really helpful for the business. So definitely please do reach out to us. One thing, just if you do have any questions, please make sure that you ask them now. Of course, as Ev said, that we want to make sure that everybody gets a chance. So there actually are a few questions coming in, which is really exciting because we absolutely adore questions here on these webinars. So one of the queries that have just come in, will there be a replay of this webinar sent? Yes, there will. So if you have signed up, you will get a recording of this webinar. So if you didn't get everything the first time, or if you just want to run through and you're just as excited about sales tax as we are, you get to watch this again. So absolutely, you will get this sent out. So what happens if you have a tax exempt service? I guess that's something that we'll probably loop in with our product team on to make sure that you have that support. My initial query is that maybe you could set your tax up just to have a 0% place or charge in place. So it depends on how your other services are. So for example, I'm not entirely sure who asked that query there, but if it's a case that you have tax inclusive or exclusive, maybe it's just the case that you apply like a 0% tax charge on that certain product. But again, I think that's something that our product team will advise on. If it's a case that whoever asked that question, because it has come in as anonymous, if you want to make yourself known, even just to myself and Ed, then we can definitely reach out and make sure that we pinpoint that query for you and get it answered. Sabrina, thank you so much for joining. So I'm glad that you have joined, and I hope everything has been clear for you so far. So when does the tax tab show up in settings? I don't see it on my end. Great question. We are in the process of rolling this out. So if it's the case that you don't have it yet on your tab, don't worry. We're doing it just bit by bit with certain regions. So if you haven't had it, you'll either have it by tomorrow or definitely at the beginning of next week. And if you're not seeing it, do reach out to us. And maybe before you reach out to us, what I would recommend is that thing that everybody hates to hear, but I'd recommend logging out and logging back in again. It's like that good old trick of turning it off and turning it back on again. That will then hopefully work and show. If it's still not working, then Sabrina, you just loop in with us. As Ev said, there's an entire squad of people here who are making sure that you get this set up. We've got a question from Sarah again. Thank you so much for joining. When does this roll out for? So that kind of, Sarah, hopefully that answers your question that I just raised and followed up with Sabrina. And excellent. I think that's all that's come in so far. So listen, folks, I know that we've ran through that, quite, I guess, concisely, but quickly as well, as we want to make sure that we're conscious of everybody's time. But as I said, there will be a recording sent out to everybody here. And this is just a quick reminder of some other products that we have at the moment, which is our e-agreement. So, you know, if you are, let's say, updating, you know, tax percentages and different ways of working, and you want to make sure that, you know, you mitigate any risk for you as a business, for your clients as well, that you definitely kind of add this on to your plan if it's a case you haven't done so already. Because this will now be a good chance to kind of, you know, revisit all of your terms and conditions, particularly in the new year. I know it's a different version of new year, new you and so on, but it still applies. So, you know, hopefully now with sales tax implemented, you'll really be able to get your February and the rest of your 2021 kicked off well. So that's very much it from the two of us. Ev, do you have anything else to add, or is that all set?
That's all set.
Excellent. Well, listen, if you have enjoyed this webinar, please do leave us a very kind review on G2 Crowd. We would be really appreciative of it. If you do have any queries and you want to kind of flag anything, be it sales tax related, e-agreements or anything else related, we are here to support you. So please reach out to customersuccess@glowfox.com. In the meantime, please keep safe, everybody, and we look forward to speaking to you on our next webinar. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks, everyone. Bye.